Hey guys, hope you're having a great life.
Finally, getting to it, Thin Lizzy.
You guys have been asking for it for over a year now.
It's been a long time.
It's time.
It's been kind of in and out of the comments, and we always mean to do it. We sit down and say, like, okay, we're going to do Thin Lizzy, and then something ends up happening. Like, there ends up being, like, an overwhelming amount of requests for a specific band or another song.
Yep. Not this time.
Not this time. No, this Thin time, Lizzy. Thin Lizzy, they're getting their shot.
We checked out their songs, and the one that we saw that caught our eye, obviously...
Whiskey in a jar.
It had to be the first song we do. It had to be.
Yeah, it just seemed cool. I don't know, man. So I feel like that's the one we're getting to, and I hope it doesn't disappoint. I have no idea what to expect because you guys just said, "Hey, do Thin Lizzy on other
what
bands."
What does
the
group
like.
Sound like? That's called Thin Lizzy, Alex. Like what is that? You know
what I'm hoping for?
Yeah.
You ever go to Chipotle?
Yeah.
All right. So you go to Chipotle, and let's say you're really hungry that day, so you get like. Okay. You get, like, double chicken and guac.
Okay.
And you pay for it. You walk to your table. You look at the receipt.
I would never get double chicken. It'd be chicken and steak.
Chicken and steak. Okay. Cool. Okay. All right. You get chicken and steak. Get chicken and steak, guac. Get to your table after you paid. Look at the bill. Realize they forgot to charge for guac.
Oh, that sounds awesome.
Sounds like an awesome... Yeah. So I'm hoping it sounds like that.
Okay. Let's go and dive into it, man.
I get it. I love it. Like,
dude.
My Molly will.
perfect. And I dare all the danger for 5, 6, or maybe 7. In one captain battle, I jumped up, fired off my pistols, and I shot him with both barrels. Mushroom, dumma dumma da. Wait for my daddy, oh. Wait for my daddy, oh. There's whiskey in the jar. My Miley's chamber, but here I am in prison. Here I am with a ball and chain. Yeah, much a ring, dumma do, dumma da. Wait for my daddy, oh. Wait for my daddy, oh. There's whiskey in the jar.
Dude,
great song.
It was a Lost in the Sauce kind of song.
Yeah, sure. That was honestly weirdly Lost in the Sauce kind of song.
Yeah, you wouldn't have thought it would have been. Even like when it started getting into the area that you did get lost in when they kept going, but like when it first started that, all that.
I was pretty much immediately lost in the sauce. I don't know what the fuck he was saying during the chorus, except for this whiskey. Something about daddy-o, there's whiskey in the jar-o.
Yeah, something like that.
Sound I'm a dee da ma da.
This is an example. So we talked about the Bruce Springsteen song where it sounds like just the guy
singing. I was singing the same thing.
It's just the guy singing. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah. But this felt like a much more like real like rendition of that type of.
This is what, like, I literally was singing the same thing. I was like,
I'm glad we're on the same page.
Dude, 100%.
Yeah.
I was like, this is the, not only the tonality that you'd expect from that, but also the passion. It has the exact same passion as the Springsteen song.
Yeah.
But also with like the vocal chops. Yeah.
Because I don't know what he was talking about at all, dude. Like in this song, I don't know what was going on.
I think he stole money from some guy, gave it to some woman who tricked him into taking all the money, and then went around with another guy, and then he killed that guy and then got put in jail and was thinking, man, I'd rather just be sleeping with that girl still.
All right. Interesting.
That's what I heard. I pieced it together. Let's see. It was kind of like,
okay.
Phone fell. Anyways, it's kind of like trying to read Braille, but you only know how to read sign language. So you're like, both of them, it require hands, right?
Yeah.
So obviously not even close. Like I was just like picking out random words.
I know what you mean.
Like I know Morse code. Can you read Braille?
Bottom line is we don't know what it was about necessarily. It was awesome though, dude. I love
the vibe. That's my vote. If I'm right, tell me in the comments.
Yeah,
but yeah,
Lost in the Sauce song for sure.
Yeah,
there was a point where I was thinking, I love how they ended the song, but I feel like it didn't drag on because it's a Lost in the Sauce kind of song, so it can go longer. But I feel like if it were a little bit shorter, it wouldn't have hurt it. Just like some of that middle chunk, I guess.
Yeah,
but I still enjoyed every second
here's the deal.
Of this.
It's also that hinges on the fact of not knowing the song's story. So maybe maybe require that last bit just to get the whole context.
But there's also context of the time, whereas when this came out and when songs were coming out in this time period, it was okay for songs to be like, I guess, if they were a Lost in the Sauce brand type of song, it was okay to be a little bit longer, you know?
Yeah, I agree.
Whereas that doesn't really skate by as much like in our modern music, you know?
Yeah, and I'll say this too. The song felt like it didn't develop a whole bunch. Yeah. Which isn't a bad thing. It's not what it was going for.
Yeah.
But I think that's what you kind of mean when you're saying, like, songs don't typically go as long now unless there's a reason for it.
Yeah.
So it's not just, like, not like they recycled parts, because this was very clearly, like, a storytelling song. So, but for most bands, like, with a song this long where you get lost in the sauce, they have you go through a couple sections of the verse and the chorus, and then they'll start changing it up, either instrumentation with, like, the bass or the drums or the... And they did change it a little bit.
Yeah.
But it was very subtle, and that's not a bad thing. I thought that was good. But I just think long term, it didn't develop production-wise the way I would have maybe liked to see it develop.
Yeah. One thing I'll say, guitar tone, dude.
I mean, that was impeccable.
Just... When the song first started, I was just like, sold.
Yeah.
Sold to Thin Lizzy.
Yeah.
And then through the song, the tone changed. It became slightly less dreamy and a little bit more sharp and bright. But no, it was awesome tone. Like, you know, the dude's having a great time.
Yeah. Tone was great. I thought the atmosphere they built was phenomenal. And so maybe it wasn't an issue that they didn't change it. I don't know. Who am I?
I don't think it was. I think this type of band is the band that you go and you see their live show, you watch their like 2-3 hour set, and you're vibing out, dude.
2 or 3 hour set?
Yeah.
You think they played for 3 hours?
You know, concerts would be like 3 hours long.
Yeah, maybe with the openers.
I guess so.
Dude, when you saw Pink Floyd, how long did they go for?
Like Roger Waters? It felt like 2.5 or 3 hours. I could be wrong, though.
Dude, I feel like 2.5, 3 hours is a long concert. I mean, I'm sure bands do it, but...
It's a super long concert,
yeah. I feel like they're like an hour, hour and a half.
Yeah. I mean, I guess...
Maybe 2 hours. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe they do play 2 hours. Guess it's been too long since
I've definitely seen like 2.5 hour... like
3 hours seems excessive, is all I'm thinking.
Yeah. Well, I've been to some Dave Matthews concerts where they play for that long, I feel like.
Oh, dude. You got me there. Dave Matthews does play for a long time.
Yeah. But they'll just turn songs from 5 minutes into like 20 minutes, and that's why, I guess.
Yeah, that's true. And then you got to set... Nah, I'm wrong. Sorry, guys. I'm definitely wrong on that one.
It's okay. But yeah, moral of the story was, I feel like this kind of band, you have to go see them live.
Oh, yeah, probably.
Like, songs like this, imagine... Although... They drag it out 10 minutes.
May I contend road trip playlist worthy?
Of course.
Yeah. I think this is song like 7 or 8 on road trip playlist.
No, I agree. Absolutely. I just meant as a general, like, just from this, like, song, I feel like this is the type of band that's, like, you can dig their studio cuts, but you can't really fully get the enjoyment unless you've seen them live.
Yeah.
You know?
That wherever they are on record, it's, like, a level above when you see them live.
Yeah, the atmosphere, people around you, everyone's kind of, like, chilling, all that good stuff. But, yeah, so that was Thin Lizzy. Are there other songs that we should check out by them? We saw a couple others that we were interested in, but, yeah.
So that being said, just let us know in the comments below, and we'll catch you on Wednesday.